The third thing we can do in our resource classrooms is we can make sure that we're building evidence of success. It's hard to feel successful if you don't have a track record of anything you've done well, right? And so the best way to build evidence of success is to make sure that students are partners in that data collection process. I work with lots of educators and we're working on so many different IEP goals and everyone's IEP goal is so different. I say, why not let students own their own IEP goals and let them collect data throughout our class period or the other classes that they're working in. Let them become partners in this process. And now they're gonna start to lead their IEP meetings and talk about, in this class, I started to master this objective, and we're really putting the keys in their hands to do a lot of this work. There's so much great research right now on even kindergartners starting to take ownership in their IEP meetings. Because again, they know their goals and they know what they're working on. Build evidence of success. Provide students opportunities to see that in this larger task, there are elements that I can start off successful. And so what I've started to see lately around this is I've seen teachers now have warm-ups that include choice or tiers, right? Something like solve this problem or this problem. And one might be a little bit of a lower tier and the other one is extending knowledge. Such a great way for students to enter into our classroom and have success versus that one problem that maybe I can't do and I don't know how to get started. Let's provide some choice so students can start to build evidence of success. Here's a great example in one of the classrooms that I have worked in which a teacher set up a ladder almost, like a step staircase up towards becoming a nonfiction reader. And so at each tier, the student starts to accumulate their own data, signaling where they fall and discussing what they're going to do to get to that next step, to get to that next ladder. So we start at the very bottom. I write the topic in one or two words with help. I can tell at least two details about the topic with help. Sometimes I copy the words exactly from the page. But then we again start to build this progression. I've started here with my success, but I'm continuing to slowly move up. And we're having conversations about how you move up as well. And the student, again, is a data partner in that process, so they know exactly where they fall. It's no surprise when it's time to take a test, right? I know exactly what skills and how I'm entering into the task.